Okay, let's talk about your mom for a second. And I want to tie this one in with your book, because I'm curious if you talk about your mom in your book. The last time we spoke, you were a judge on the panel for Pretty Wicked. And you said that you helped the girls by sharing your experiences with them. You mentioned drugs and self-harming and issues with your mother. Is this stuff that you speak about in your book?
Yeah, the book was... originally, it was just kind of a story about a girl and her mom, you know, me and my mom. And as I was making it, I really started opening up about my mom. And I just thought people should read about that, because I think the things I went through with my mom, a lot of people go through. And that was one of the pros for me being a judge on Pretty Wicked, was that a lot of these girls had, you know, mom issues. And that's one thing that I can really kind of hone in on. You know, we all have issues with our parents. We always want our parents to be what they're not, you know?
And, yeah, yeah.
And the one thing we all have to understand is that, you know, sometimes we have to just let them be who they are and accept that and stop trying to change them. And, you know, the same goes for parents trying to change their kids. It's just kind of a normal human reaction. But yeah, I talk a lot about my mom in my book. She's the main focus for sure.
What is the book called?
It's called Creating Myself. I was trying to find a title, and, you know, it was the end of the book, and I had to submit it, and I didn't know what to do, and I just started thinking about my life and how I spent a lot of time, almost wasting time, trying to figure myself out and figure the world out and find myself and, you know, all those questions that we have. And I realized that, you know, life isn't about finding yourself, but it's about creating yourself and mm-hmm. creating the world that you live in, and taking ownership for the things that you do. And so I just simply titled it Creating Myself.
I really like the thought process you put behind that, honestly.
Yeah, I mean, I think so many people, their brains are just stuck in this other world, you know, where they listen to what other people say.
And yeah.
I'm a firm believer that, you know, no one else has the right to tell you or make you feel emotions. You know, you have to kind of take ownership and maybe block that off. There's so many women out there that have low self-esteem because people in their family say rude things about their weight or
things
like that. And it's like, you know, they'd get so much further in life if they just had a little thicker skin and just brushed it off and did the things that they wanted to do and, you know, stop trying to figure it all out and just kind of create your own world and do the things that you have to.
Yeah. Okay, I have a few fun questions I want to take a look at. Let's talk about, I guess, like reality TV. You have your fair share of TV and film. You did Celebrity Fit Club, Pretty Wicked last year, Rush Hour 3. Do you have a reality obsession? That's not American Idol, because you tweet quite a bit about Adam Lambert.
You know, I got rid of my television in August, my cable, because I was so consumed with every single reality show. And I just thought, you know what, this is really taking up... This is kind of wasting my time because I'm getting so caught up in everyone else's lives. Reality TV is probably one of the greatest inventions that ever happened.
Mm-hmm.
Because what are we? We're people watchers. Everyone loves to watch people.
Yeah.
And so you put that in a format where it's at your fingertips. And I had, you know, DVR, so I was recording everything.
Everything, yeah.
I was finding that I wasn't leaving my house, and I was like, well, no, I have to, you know, I can't come out because I'm watching, you know, this. And I was like, I can't do this anymore. So I've actually... This is the first year I haven't watched American Idol, too, which is kind of starting to get to me.
Uh-huh.
So I'm either going to have to start watching it online or figure something out. But, yeah, and that's the thing. Like, I'm perfectly content with leaving last year's American Idol as my last one watching.
Yeah.
Because I love Adam Lambert.
Uh-huh.
I mean, I knew watching the show that he was totally gay. How could he not be? And and I he's the hottest man in the world to me. I have the biggest crush on him, and... one of my really good friends is in his band.
Yeah.
So like we have, so I'm like that much closer to him, and we actually haven't hung out yet, but we always talk about it. And
yeah.
He's just so adorable, and I always tell my boyfriend, I'm like, would you let me make out with Adam? Even though I don't think Adam wants to make out with me, but I think he's like the hottest guy in the world. So that's,
you know, speaking of guys that you think that are hot, here's a quote that I like. It says, Jesus, when did this happen? It's amazing how tattoos can make things look so good. I want it. This is a reference to John Mayer on Rolling Stone.
Oh, absolutely. You know what? I'm not a big John Mayer music fan.
Yeah.
I think he's an amazing musician, but I don't really listen to his music. And I knew he had a couple tattoos, but I had no idea. I guess I'm just one of those girls that you get tattoos and then I think you're hot. And I love a guy with tattoos and a guy with a sleeve. I don't care what your face looks like. That arm is just so beautiful that I just want to, like, stare at you. So when I saw that picture, my friend had it on her Facebook, and my jaw dropped. And
Major
I totally
Sloan.
I did a double take, and I was like, oh, my God. And I saved the picture to my computer, and I actually waited a couple days, and I was like, I have to Twitter about this. Because my boyfriend's out of town, and I was just like, I'm bored. And I was like, I'm just going to stare at this picture. And It's funny because I put it on my Facebook and it caused a whole ruckus because everyone was like, well, do you like John Mayer? And then all these people started going back and forth about his music and what it, you know, saying he's a douche. And I was like, he's not a douche. He's really funny and he's smart and clearly good looking now.
Yeah. So you clearly like the whole art thing. Now you have several tattoos on your body. If you had to pick one that's your favorite, what would it be?
Yeah, somebody just asked me that yesterday and I was like, God, because I consider my sleeves as one now.
Yeah.
I don't know. I have a couple matching tattoos with my best friend because I love her. I call her my non-sexual life partner.
Yeah.
Because she's like my perfect relationship without all the, you know, insanity that goes along with sleeping with somebody. So we have a couple matching ones, so I'd probably say some of those are my favorite. We got a matching Vegas tattoo because we go to Vegas a lot, and I don't know. Everyone seems to like that.
Where is it?
It's on my arm. I'll send you a picture.
Okay. Sounds good. I'll hold you to that. What about a movie? If you had to pick one movie for us to watch, what do you love?
Because my boyfriend is a filmmaker, he's opened my eyes to some of the funniest movies I've ever seen. And I don't know if you've ever heard of the series Trailer Park Boys. They have a movie, too, and it's pretty much the funniest thing I've ever seen. So I would say Trailer Park Boys. If you guys want to watch something funny and absolutely ridiculous.
If you're going to recommend it, I'll definitely have a look, that's for sure.
It's so silly, and it's so white trash, and I love it.
All right, signature cocktail. What do you get when you're at a bar?
I'm not much of a big drinker anymore, so I would probably just have a beer or maybe some wine. I used to be a really big fan of Pabst Blue Ribbon. It gives me headaches now, so I'll usually drink a little Stella, and if it comes in a glass, you pour a little salt in it. But I'm not really a big drinker, so. But I do like wine.
Yeah.
But I don't count that. I mean, I don't associate wine with, like, alcohol.
That doesn't count.
Yeah.
Okay. In 1979, Aerosmith released an album, Night in the Ruts. There's a song on there your dad wrote for you. If I asked you to pick a song that you wanted the world to listen to, would you pick that song or would you pick something else?
I mean, it's a good song. It's one of those songs that a lot of people associate with war because it's called Mia. And
yeah.
So I think a lot of people associate that with, like, missing in action.
Mm-hmm.
And I was actually out with my dad once at dinner once, and this man came up to my dad and was like, you know, I got to tell you, my favorite song is Mia. You know, I'm a war veteran. And he was like, you know, that's actually written about my daughter. And the guy was just like, wow, I thought that was like a war song. But it's one of those songs that it totally makes me cry when I hear it. And he always sings it. We always sing it together when we're around each other. And it's a pretty cute song.
You have these lyrics tattooed too, right?
Yeah, I do. The part I have tattooed on me was kind of for my mom. That song was to my mom. He was basically singing to her.
Yeah.
It's about me and having a new baby and stuff. So I wanted to do, you know, I wanted to do mom tattoos. So I got my mom tattooed on me, and I wanted to do her portrait on me, which I'm still going to do. But the lyrics, I don't know, I didn't have anything from my dad, and I thought that's a good mix of the both of them.
Yeah. That makes sense. What about your health and fitness regimen? What do you do for your figure?
I've actually been pretty bad lately because, you know, when you get into a relationship and you just get lazy and you're happy and so you start eating.
And it's nothing but hot Cheetos after 9 p.m., yep.
Yeah, and he's, you know, he's a filmmaker and an editor, so he's always kind of sitting in front of the computer and snacking. But I've been trying to cook really healthy and make us dinner and stuff because I love cooking. But I just recently, I found this picture of myself from right before I got married, so probably 2002, and I was about 30 pounds lighter than I'm at now. And I decided that I kind of want to try and see if I can get to that again.